I got you, Kissy.
Afraid to make money, and you're never going to be able to up level your business to the multiple six figure or seven figure arena. Afraid to do the sales call, you're afraid to make money, and you're never going to be able to up level your business to the multiple six figure or seven figure arena. And hi everyone, so I just came on here to get some things off my chest because I am feeling some type of way right now. So what basically happened is men keep blowing up my inbox. They blow up my inbox on Facebook. I have like 2 business pages on Facebook, 3, and then I have this page. They blow up my inbox on Instagram, and men are just always blowing up my inbox. And today a man inboxed me, and he basically asked me, he was just like, you know what, you're so amazing, you're so lovely, you're so wonderful, like you're like dynamic, you're beautiful, you're smart, your energy is beautiful, you're so powerful, you're magical, I've never seen anything like you before, but why can't you just like not be about money, and why can't you just be about love, and why can't a man just be good enough for you if all he has to offer you is love? And sometimes when men do that to me, like I get really, really sad, and I get sad that people don't believe in themselves. And you know, people, not only do people not believe in themselves, and you know, this man told me that he said, what you're doing is not something that everyone else can do. And he thinks I live in this like little fantasy world. And the crazy thing about it is men, so many men follow me because you're attracted to me, but you don't realize why you're attracted to me. You're attracted to me because I am a being of light. And as a being of light, that means I have dedicated my life to God. I have worked on myself tirelessly. I mean, I have invested tens and thousands of dollars into myself, into my mind. And so for a man to, here's the thing. Number one, as a man, the reason why you feel like you don't have anything to offer a woman but love is, the number one reason is, you're not paying enough attention to God. Because if you were following God, you would literally understand that you are fucking infinite. You are powerful. You are limitless. Like, you could do anything you want with your life. But for some reason, like, a lot of you men are stuck in this belief system that you are limited, that you're incapable of doing the things you want with your life. And then you want a woman like me to actually want you. Like, why would a boss chick want a man who doesn't even freaking believe in himself? And men like you, when you don't believe in yourselves, all you do is pull boss chicks down, because you're always telling us like we want too much and we're doing too much, and all I got to do is offer you is love. Like, no, you weren't created for that. Women were created to be loved by a man. But love is freaking expensive. Love does not pay the bills. And women are boss chicks. The reason we are boss chicks is because we like taking care of our families. We like providing for our families. We like having nice things. We're not trying to go without. Like, we really don't depend on men. We're not trying to go without. We are boss chicks because we want to change the world. So if you as a man, you don't want to change the world, why would you think a boss chick wants to be with you? Like, you men who don't want to do anything with their lives, like, y'all slow boss chicks down with your bullshit mentality because you don't understand your purpose. Like, as a man, you should have a purpose. You should want something out of life, and you should want to provide for your family, your woman, your kids, and everyone in your life. Like, y'all don't have no business inboxing a woman of my caliber, flirting with me for what? I don't have anything nice to say to you when you inbox me. If you're on in my comments, and I understand men fall in love with me, and that's like part of the reason why I was like really hesitant in being nice online and showing my authentic self, because so many men start inboxing me, and I'm not complaining, but that shit is overwhelming with how many men inbox me. Like, y'all all want my time and attention, and I'm not here for that. Like, I'm here to do something with my life. I have things to do in this world. I am building a powerful platform so that one day when I go to Africa, that I'm not just in Africa just to visit and be cute, that I can actually maybe donate $500,000 and get a village built and contribute to their actual economy. Like, we're not sitting here doing these things just for the heck of it. Like, it's just way deeper than the money. I have a purpose. As a man, you should have a purpose. And this is the thing. Like, men, when y'all don't have a purpose and y'all be with that, all I got to do is offer a woman with love, y'all slow boss chicks down because y'all not trying to do anything with y'all lives. And then you want a woman to respect you. What is there to respect when a man doesn't believe in himself? If you even just read the Bible, it says you are a king. If you don't believe you are a king, like, God told you you were a king. Like, what is a woman supposed to do with you if you don't believe in yourself? Like, I really just don't get it. And then men like y'all who inbox me with y'all limited lack mindset, like, y'all are like our drains to my soul and drains to my system, which is kind of the reason why I talk to y'all the way I do. I don't talk to powerful, influential men like that. Powerful, influential men, thank God for them, because women like me need men like that in our life. That's like, here, Kissy, let me show you a better way to make seven figures. Let me show you how to invest your money. Let me show you how to up-level your mindset. Like, a man who is not on his purpose, you can't do nothing with a man like a woman like me. You can't do nothing with me. You can't do nothing for me. Women need more than dick and love. You can't pay bills with dick and love. And then how many times do I have to say what y'all don't understand about boss chicks is, boss chicks, we take care of plenty of people with the money we make. And if we have the heart to take care of several people, how do you as a man not have the heart to take care of several people? Like, the things y'all say absolutely make zero sense. But guess what? When a woman is with a man like Jeff Bezos, what she can do? She can donate $500,000 to charity. She can go build a village in Africa. She can go freaking adopt 12 kids in Africa if she wants to. She can actually do things and contribute to the world. And here's the thing, like, men, y'all don't understand, when y'all are not about nothing, y'all would take a woman like me and literally tell me, like, oh, you need to humble yourself. Oh, you want too much out of life. Like, why would you want a Bentley? You need a Toyota. You need to be satisfied with anything. And y'all would have a woman like me thinking that I'm average and that I'm nobody and that I'm not important. And I wouldn't be out here changing the world if I was with a man like one of y'all. Y'all don't do women no good, and y'all just do not get that. And I'm telling you, if you are following a woman as powerful and as brilliant as me, and as much as I talk about God, if you haven't caught on to that belief system, like, you got a serious problem. And the last thing y'all need to do is be in some badass chicks like mine inbox. For what? Why don't you be in a book? Go take a course. Go read a book. Go watch a YouTube video to inform yourself. Like, y'all is just absolutely ridiculous. ridiculous. And I don't know why y'all don't get it. Like, y'all depressed women, y'all drained women. When a woman is with a rich man, you know why women want to be with rich men? Because then she can do what she wants to do with her life. She doesn't have to focus on bending over backwards to pay the bills, washing your dishes, cleaning for you, doing a million and one things, because then you think she your mama. Rich men don't think women are their mom. They understand that a woman is to be loved, that we contribute with femininity. We don't contribute to men with money. Boss chicks, we make money. Yes, we are powerful. Yes, but still, we want men at our level because we are so super giving. And then that's another thing. Y'all be in my inbox. If I was to even deal with one of y'all men, you wouldn't even be able to handle me because I would smash you like a bug. Every morning you got up, you don't got no money. I would be like, dude, why you don't got no money? Why you ain't do A, B, C, D, and E? Like, no man wants to hear that. So y'all be trying to deal with high-level chicks. Y'all can't even handle us. Like, seriously, y'all can't handle us. Like, we work y'all under the table because we have a purpose to birth in this world. And if you want to change the world, yes, that takes money. You cannot change the world without money. Nobody is going to listen to the broke man in the corner with nothing to offer a woman. And as a man, like I said, you should want to offer a woman more than just dick and fucking smiles. Like, I just think y'all are so freaking ridiculous. And it'd be like, I'd be trying to be so sweet and kind to y'all because I understand that everybody has a certain belief system, but I don't have no sympathy for y'all. I just don't. Like, I grew up in the projects. Like, I never met my father. I grew up on welfare and food stamps. Like, man, that shit was crazy. Like, I've been in abusive relationships. I've been homeless. I've been so many things where I should have never made it this far. And you know what I do? I get up every single day and I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna work hard because I still want to accomplish my dreams. I still have to get up and I have to believe in myself. And I'm a woman. I'm literally a woman. I'm a woman that's so beautiful. I could literally go get a man to really just take care of me, provide for me, and do nothing with my life but shop. But I still choose to get up because I want to see other people live the life of their dreams. I want to see other people believe in themselves. I want to see women confident and happy. I want to see the men in my tribe who are ballers, who are doing something with their life. I want to see them with women who actually appreciate them and value them so that people can be a power couple and do something to change this world. And that's another thing. Like, people, y'all be saying, y'all have this belief system that rich people suck. Rich people are the ones that's paying the taxes. Rich people are the ones that's inventing things. Rich people are the ones that's employing people. Rich people literally change the world. You cannot change the world if you don't have no money. So as I was saying, like, I would really appreciate if every single man with no money would stay out of my inbox. Do every beautiful woman a favor and stay out of her inbox. Y'all belong in the comment section to be supportive and to say nice things. And like I said, I'm telling y'all, y'all have a serious problem. If you follow a woman as smart as me and you don't pick up on no game, you should be motivated. Like, if you really feel like, oh, I'm so magical, I'm so beautiful, and you want a woman like me, then why are you not inspired enough to say, you know what, I want a woman like that, so I'm gonna get up off my butt and I'm gonna do what it takes to get some money in my life? No, what y'all do instead is y'all inbox us complaining and whining. And then some of y'all be in the comments like, oh, well, what if a man runs out of money? Then what is he gonna do? What is she gonna do? Like, that's y'all belief system. Y'all always focus on what if something goes wrong? What if something goes bad? Like, who do y'all be listening to? Like, do y'all not hear all these men around here saying multiple sources of income, invest, have a product, have multiple products, have multiple stores? I mean, it's just so simple. I'm not gonna say it's a piece of cake, but it is a piece of cake once you catch on. And this is the thing about women. Boss chicks come up with ideas. We are full of money making ideas. Power couples have money because there's two minds in a relationship that are building wealth together. A boss chick cannot build wealth with a man with a scarcity mentality. She just can't. She can't do anything with him. Y'all don't even value a beautiful woman. If you valued beautiful woman, then you would actually have some money to be able to afford one. Stop feeling like women are supposed to be beautiful, and then after all that hard work she has put in, because this is expensive. Looking like this is expensive. Looking like this is a lot of work. And then expecting she's supposed to just sit down in a corner, in the alley, in the garbage to love you. You don't love yourself as a man if you don't get up and get some money to provide for your woman, your family, and your kids. You like, I really, seriously, I do not get you men who don't want no money. And I don't even try to understand y'all. And you know what I'm gonna do? I'm actually going to start blocking y'all, because it's not even like, I got Unicorn University. Any of you men could have joined Unicorn University and got your mind right. There's so many opportunities to work with me and get your mind right. There is no excuses. I'm not even trying to hear excuses from men saying you can't find a good woman, because all you had to do was work with me. You would have found a good woman. I've been inside Millionaire Soulmate Charm School for what, like a year. You know how many lives have been changed inside of that group? And that is a free group. Y'all don't care enough about yourself to change your life. And it's like, I get upset. Why do I have to be the one to tell you? Why can't I just be like the sweet doting girl? And then that's the thing, when I come on here and I'm like, yeah, you know, I've been heartbroken, or this man did this to me, this man did that to me, like, I tell those stories, but I don't tell those stories as sob stories. But then anytime I tell one of those stories, then one of you men come in my inbox like, who you think I was heartbroken by? I wasn't heartbroken by some rich man who was on his paper. I was heartbroken by some 9-to-5 dudes who needed my money. And y'all see how that goes? Because that's what y'all are going to do. Anytime a man gets with a boss chick and she's doing better than him, you're going to get upset with that woman, because instead of just letting you be a nobody and happy being a nobody, she is going to start uplifting you. She's going to start speaking life into you. She's going to start making you believe in yourself. And then once you start believing in yourself and seeing life a new way, you're going to hate that woman because she was dealing with you when you didn't have nothing, when you didn't love yourself. And that's the thing, if you even read the Bible, it says a man should love a woman the way God loves her. God is the King of Kings. He is a protector and a provider. So if you want to be anything like a good man, then protect and provide. Because you know what? 95% of the men in the world do not protect and provide. That's why there is so many single women. That's why so many women don't even know how to get along in a relationship with a good man, because she's so used to having to drag a man along and build a bear. And that's another thing, y'all need to stop even looking at women, calling women gold diggers. You gotta have some gold to be able to call a woman a gold digger, and the average woman isn't even a gold digger. Gold diggers don't even, they don't even deal with y'all. Like, y'all can't even afford the gold digger. So like I said, don't be on my page complaining, because I'm just gonna block y'all. Like, I'm so sick and tired of men who don't want to do anything with their lives. Like, y'all would literally frustrate my mission if I didn't have some sense and know that that's just the way y'all is. And y'all got to get up and you got to love yourself. And then another thing with women, y'all keep saying the same thing, like, oh my God, I'm waiting on Jesus to send me a man, this and that. Like, y'all make excuses too. Like, the reason you don't have the type of man you want is because you're not being the feminine woman you're supposed to be. A lot of y'all women, y'all don't know how to talk to men. Y'all talk to men the way I talk to scrubs. Like, I don't talk to the men who invest in me and who are smart. I don't talk to them the way I talk to scrubs. I talk to them two completely different ways, because with one man, that's feminine. With the other man, you know what? Yeah, I'm just going to be my little aggressive. I'm going to get my masculinity off on him, because why? You don't have to respect a man who don't respect himself. And if you don't want to make money, you don't want to be a millionaire as a man, you don't respect yourself. And if y'all want some powerful woman to love y'all, y'all need to get that powerful woman before she realizes who she is, before she wakes up. Because even me, there was a time I was asleep. That's how I was in 50-50 relationships, because I was asleep. I wasn't owning my authority and my power. So anyways, I'm gonna tell y'all this one more time. I'm gonna put a link in the comments. It's God, Money, and Manifestation. If you want to learn how God actually operates, because God wants you to have everything you want in this world. Like, God gave everybody a purpose. Everybody is carrying greatness. But you can't just be great. You have to get up every single day of your life and do the work it takes to be great. That means you have to get up and solve problems in society. That's how this world works, is by solving problems. People have problems. Get up and figure out how you can solve some problems. If you can't solve no problems, you're not doing anything in this world. And y'all, I mean, this epidemic that happened, sitting around and seeing how, you know, just waiting on a check, like, you should be able to see right now how that works. That's not what's up. Everybody makes money on the internet, so that's what anybody with some sense should be doing right now. And instead of, like I said, instead of being in women's inbox who are actually doing something, annoying her, taking up her time for free, why don't y'all go do something with your lives? Like, I have men inside Unicorn University Tribe who I run their credit card every single month, and they don't even log in. They don't. They just support my mission. And you know what? Men like that are better. Yes. Not only are those men better, when I have a problem with my mindset, because not many people can help me at my level, it's one of those men that I talk to, and they say, okay, Kissy, this is how you do A, B, C, D, and E. So that's the thing. You men, y'all ain't even studying enough to be able to assist a woman like me in this lifetime. And a woman like me, boss chicks want a man that she can be proud of. Like, we don't like looking down at men. Like, no woman wants a scrub. No woman wants to look at her man as a scrub. And boss chicks, I'm telling y'all, so many boss chicks, this is what I know what boss chicks do, because I've done this behavior. We have tried to be with the 50-50 men. I remember I would be going to Ruth Chris, Del Frisco's, Miami. I would be traveling vacation all over the world. I'm staying at the Fountain Blue in Miami at the penthouse. I'm paying for everything. And I'm with a man, but I'm paying for everything because that is my lifestyle and my upkeep. So y'all be like, y'all can't call boss chicks gold diggers. We make our own money. That's why we don't listen to nothing y'all trying to say. We not trying to hear it, because we've done it already. And the only thing else I can do for y'all men is I'm writing a book. And I told y'all, I'm writing a book to teach you how to get a high value woman. That's also going to teach you how to be a high value man and get some money. And I said, okay, pre-sales, did y'all buy the book? You know who bought my book? Men who are already highly successful. See how this thing goes? My tribe is successful. There's no point. Y'all be like, Kissy, why you don't do this for this group of people? Kissy, why you don't do that for that group of people? If you don't want no money and you don't want to be rich, you're not my tribe. You're just not my tribe. Like, I've tried to help y'all. I'm so strong and confident in what I do because I didn't try it all, and I know better. It's a waste of time. It is my waste of my breath trying to help men who don't want to do nothing with their life. It's a waste of my breath trying to help these masculine women who don't want to be feminine, and they just want to keep doing things the same way they've been doing it. And I've told them a million times, like, even me, when I came up on these conscious, enlightened men who have your back, and they're going to protect, and they're going to provide, and they're going to just be the man you always wanted them to be, like, that's a different type of man. That man requires a different type of woman. And yeah, we have to learn how to talk to such a man. We have to learn how to attend to such a man's needs. And we have to learn how to fit into his world, because he doesn't need our money. And most boss chicks, we're used to men who need our money. They need our knowledge. But that's not what powerful men need. Powerful men just need a woman to be feminine and to understand him and to be there by his side and to be his comfort, and so that he knows he always has somebody who has his back when he's out in the world. And it's tough out in the world. He's dealing with a whole bunch of masculine energy. So when he comes in the house, he just needs a sweet feminine woman to, you know, just make him laugh and make him smile, and so he can just, you know, relax. And that's the way it goes. And like I said, I'm about to post a link after this God, Money, and Manifestation. The course is, how much is the course? It's $199, and that's only because it's beta mode. I'm just now launching it. I'm going to sell it for like $2,000 later. So, man, if you want to work with me, you can work in there. If you want to have access to me, Unicorn University Tribe is what? It's only $111 a month right now. If you can't afford $111 a month, there's really no point of you inboxing me. Like, seriously. Like, it's not like I hide the fact that I love money. I love getting money. I love doing things with my life. So if you're not the type of man who loves to do things with your life, me and you just not my type. And I don't feel bad about that. And no woman is going to feel bad that you're not willing to rise and be the king that God called you to be. Because if you even read the Bible, it says God gave everybody gifts. And what? One of the men, I don't know which of the stories it is, but one of the men, what did he go do? He went and buried his gift because he was scared. Meanwhile, everybody else multiplied their gift. And that's what all these boss chicks are doing. They're multiplying their gifts. They're creating clothing companies. They're creating makeup companies. They're becoming life coaches. They're changing the world. Why is you a man? Why can't you get up and change the world? So anyways, that's all I had to say. I had to get that back off my chest. And now I have to go back to Goddess Unleashed and finish what I finished in there. You know, I was doing a really good video in there about, you know, just becoming the woman that God called you to be. Because as a woman, you're not going to get what you want out of life until you become the woman that God called you to be. And you know, none of us are perfect. We all have to work on ourselves, and there's nothing wrong with not being perfect, but at the same time, we should all keep trying to be perfect, right? Because this is something we're never going to reach. So if it's something we're never going to reach, we're just going to keep becoming better and better and better people. And that's what life is all about. It's about becoming a better person so that you can have better connections, so that when you leave this earth, you can leave a legacy and say, oh, you know what? I actually did something with the world. I actually put it all out on the line. And so when you're 90, you can really just chill. And that's the thing. Like, If y'all don't get it, go buy a Bible. Go read a New English Version Bible. Because if you listen to the world telling you what you can't have, you're just going to keep not having. You are your belief system. I don't know how many times I need to say that. You're going to get what you believe you're going to get out of life. And I'm not doing anything that's impossible. The only thing that I do is I outwork people. I don't rest on my beauty. I literally get up and I work. And you know what? That's what men are supposed to do, period.
Fuck with, I did them scandalous.